like a new day is coming.
I'll start all over. I'll start all over. A new day. A new day. Yeah. I'll start all over. I'll start all over. A new day. A new day. A new day. A new day.
Hello, Grizzlies. My name is Cliff Mitchell, and it is an honor for me to be our principal here at Mission Hills High School. I'd like to thank you for all of your patience this year and everything that you've gone through this past academic year. I know it's been hard at times, and I know that you've persevered throughout all of it. I wanted to share with you how excited we are to get all of you back in our classrooms. Our teachers are in their rooms right now, preparing, making those final preparations for our rooms for you to return. They are preparing final lessons, getting everything set and ready for you. Our ASB is on campus, and they too are planning events for us this year. In fact, they hosted our senior sunrise this morning, a phenomenal event dedicated to our seniors. We also have Link Crew coming early next week to do campus tours for our freshmen and anyone new to Mission Hills. The campus is abuzz, it is full of energy, and in fact, the only thing that is missing right now is you. You're going to hear from a lot of people today, just getting us ready and telling us how to safely get on campus and what our day will look like. One thing that I can share with you is that we're going to be asking everyone to wear their ID card on a lanyard, which you'll be getting when we return to school. We look forward to seeing you really soon, and we're really excited to meet you, to reconnect with you, and to get our school year underway. Thanks, Grizzlies.
Once you come to campus at one of our three entrances, please be ready to show your Lumisite on your phone or printed. You'll go through one line and get checked by our staff, again with it on your phone or printed. If you don't, you'll go through a slightly different line where you'll get temperature checked and we'll log you in with a Chromebook. Again, if you have it on your phone or printed, it'll be a lot quicker. We have some new necessary items for campus. Please get ready to wear your mask, bring your Chromebook, your charger, and a water for everyday school. We're gonna have the same bell schedule as we did at the beginning of the year with period one starting at 8:30. We'll be ready to have students come in at 7:40 a.m. Zero period, please get dropped off at the front admin lot. Thank you for what you're all doing to keep our campus safe.
When you come onto campus, you're gonna see some modifications and additions that we've made in the hopes of keeping everybody safe and healthy. We've moved tables out here to promote social distancing. We have additional hand washing stations throughout campus. We've created a traffic pattern of all students going up the stairs in the front and down the stairs in the back. In addition, we've added signage throughout the campus to promote social distancing and safe protocols.
This year, for the first time, we'll have two lunches happening on campus, first lunch and second lunch. How do you know which lunch you go to? If you look on your student view account, you will see it says Advisory 1 or Advisory 2. If it has Advisory 1, you go to Advisory first. So if you're going to Advisory, maybe you're going to Mr. Woodman's Advisory. Off you go. Let's wave. Off he goes to Advisory. While that's happening, first lunch is happening. You see our ladies here at lunch. All the lines are not open. Every other one is open. If you could maintain your 6 feet distance while you're in line, we'd appreciate it. Also on campus, we have a lot more tables and chairs for you to sit at. Again, just make sure you have 6 feet of distance between you. After first lunch and after first advisory, we switch. If you had lunch, now you go to advisory. If you had advisory, now you go to lunch. Thanks, Chris.
This weekend, make sure that you log into Student View on a computer or on your phone so that you can review your schedule in preparation for in-person learning starting next week. Counselors are busy making adjustments to your schedule, and we want to make sure that you are viewing the most up-to-date current schedule that's listed for you for in-person learning. When you log into Student View on a computer or on your phone, look for those three lines in the upper right-hand corner or the little arrow that's pointing down. When you click on it, you'll see Schedule, Term 1, Term 2. Be sure to click on Term 2. When you click on Term 2, all of your classes will appear, including what advisory you have, what lunch you have, and cohort. When it says cohort, it'll be listed as Cohort A or Cohort B. That is your track. So if it's Cohort A, that means you are Track A. If it says Cohort B, you are Track B. Remember, Track A, or Cohort A, has in-person learning on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and Cohort B, Track B, has in-person learning on Wednesdays and Fridays. On Tuesday or Wednesday, depending on which track you have, when you come to school, make sure that when you enter your classes, that you do not touch the splash guards that are set up or move the tables. The tables and splash guards are set up to ensure proper safety protocols are met with social distancing. Thank you, and I look forward to seeing everybody on Tuesday or Wednesday, depending on what cohort you're in.
Code Queens will be hosting a spring virtual extended hackathon this year. This is open to all high school girls, and make sure to register by Friday, April 2nd. For more information, click the link in the description.
Hi everyone, it's that time of year again when the San Marcos Promise hosts a future fair, but of course, virtually. This year we have a wide variety of schools hosting panels from March 22nd to March 26th. We will be having some of our students' favorites such as UCLA, UCSD, UCI, Cal Poly SLO, Point Loma Nazarene, University of Oregon, UC Berkeley, Northern Arizona University, Pima Medical, and many more. This year, in order to prepare for the Future Fair, head on over to the Future Fair website at bit.ly/TSMPFutureFair. Once you are there, make sure to check out the different features the website holds, such as the speakers that will be attending, the different school exhibitors, as well as how to find your super strong code. This code, provided by Vita Novice, will be vital for your journey in the Future Fair as it helps you uncover your social strengths. The Super Strong test is super fast and takes less than 5 minutes to complete. Lastly, when you are ready, head to the homepage and sign up for the events via WUVA. WUVA is a platform that hosts virtual conferences and can be used either through a laptop or by downloading the WUVA app. With the WUVA app, you can access all the event details such as a Q&A session that range from how to pay for college to sessions that match with your RiaSet code. You can also access exhibitors alphabetically as well as the speakers that will be present at the panels. In addition, if you are having a hard time managing the app, there is a WUVA guide feature that can help you out. At the bottom of the app, you can access the agenda day by day, the attendees, and community chats. So get ready, students of Mission Hills, to blast off to success.
In a world where a pandemic brings students further apart than ever, they must rally together. But in this case, they must clash. Because only one class can be named the true champion.
I only call you when it's half past, but the only time that I'd be back.
Hey Grizzlies, Mrs. Wismer here. Just wanted to let you know that the Grizzly Writing Den will be resuming the Thursday after spring break. That's Thursday, April 8th. And we've switched the times from 11:30 to 12:40 to accommodate both tracks. Don't forget to join our Google Classroom page, and that way you can access all the wonderful writing resources. Also, if you could fill out that Google form before each visit, we'd sure appreciate it. Looking forward to seeing you. Bye.
Oh, yo, what's that? Hey, yo, look, an egg.
What's up, Grizzlies? We're so excited to have you guys back on campus. Next week, on Thursday and Friday, that's the 25th and the 26th of March, ASB is hosting a spring egg hunt. If you find these yellow eggs around campus at lunch, go ahead and open it up, look what it says, and then go up to the ASB room to claim your prize. All right, Grizzlies, so make sure it's one egg per person. If you find an egg, that's it. You can't find any more, unfortunately. But once you find the egg, we're gonna mosey on over to the ASB room, and we'll bring it up here where you can claim your prize.
One prize that is available to win is the sick Mission Hills High School bracelets.
So our model Dushin here is showing off one of our prizes, senior apparel. All right, guys, this is another prize that can be claimed, a nice Grizzlies towel. And then another prize is this nice Mission Hills lanyard.
That's the 25th and the 26th during both lunches. That means cohort A and B have chances to find eggs.
Make sure you find the eggs, Grizzlies.
Hello, welcome back to Comfort Critters. In today's corner, we have hedgehogs. There are 17 different species of hedgehog, and none of them are native to America. Hedgehogs are unfortunately illegal in some parts of the United States. These include Arizona, California, Georgia, Hawaii, Pennsylvania, and New York City, as well as Washington, D.C. And hedgehog has between 5,000 and 7,000 quills. Hedgehogs rely on hearing and smell because they have extremely poor eyesight. Unlike porcupine quills, hedgehogs' bites are not barbed and they're not poisonous. In New Zealand, a satirical politician party tried to get a hedgehog elected into parliament. Unfortunately, it did not work. Thank you for listening and have a great day.